I recently wondered if the increased use of earbuds could be contributing to hearing loss. In today's video, I'm going to talk about youth and hearing loss. Youth today are more susceptible to hearing loss than youth several years ago due to the use of earbuds and the constant stimulation of sound. Welcome, if you're new to my channel, my name is Emily. I created Definite Hearing as a way to increase awareness for the deaf and hard of hearing. I'm hard of hearing myself and I wear hearing aids. I've worn them since I was 4 months old. I love them so much. I recently came across a study that was conducted in 2011. This study wanted to see if youth in the 2000s were dealing with hearing loss more than youth in the early 80s. Throughout the years, there has been a National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey. This survey surveyed 2,928 participants in the early 80s and examined 1,771 participants in 2005 to 2006. The researchers of this study wanted to understand the prevalence of hearing loss. They noticed that the prevalence of hearing loss in these groups of children ages 12 to 19 jumped almost 5% between those two different generations. The prevalence of hearing loss in the first group was 14.9%. The prevalence of hearing loss in the second group was 19.5%. This is significant. This means that over the course of about 25 years, the youth in America's hearing loss increased by almost 5%. Researchers noticed that these hearing losses were typically unilateral and the losses were in the high frequencies. High frequencies are more known for speech frequencies, especially in female voices. I struggle to hear female voices myself. I prefer to hear male voices from males without beards or mustaches. Therefore, these researchers found that the hearing loss in youth from 1988 to 1994 was significantly greater than youth ages 12 through 19 in 2005 to 2006. Should we be concerned about this? In my opinion, yes, we should be concerned about this. Hearing loss is not normal. Our ears are our senses and they should be taken care of. A lot of people think, if I have a mild loss, why should I treat it? It's only mild. The thing is, our brain needs this auditory stimulation to be able to process, not just to process sound, but to understand what's going on around us and to keep our minds healthy and active. Researchers feel that the increase of this hearing loss across youth is due to the increased use of earbuds and headphones. Humanity has not been used to the introduction of sound and the constants of listening to sound like we do in these days. So as I reviewed this study, I thought about my own earphone use and my headphone use. My hearing aids are my earbuds. I can stream via Bluetooth music straight from my phone to my hearing aids. And believe me, music has never sounded better because my hearing aids can attune the sound and bump those levels that I need to hear based on my hearing loss. So I guess the critical question is, am I damaging my hearing loss by aiding it? I think you could go both ways, especially based on this study. But without my hearing aids, I can barely hear anything. Imagine submerging yourself in water. That's what my hearing sounds like without hearing devices. At least that's what I think it sounds like. It might sound different because when I'm submerged underwater, I cannot hear a thing. My hearing loss is rated as moderate to severe, so I have a hearing loss between 65 to 80 decibels. This is quite significant. Most people don't realize how significant this is because of how well I speak. And I speak well because my parents chose to aid my hearing loss. They fit me with hearing aids right after they found out I had a hearing loss, and I've been able to hear and develop as my hearing peers throughout my life. I am extremely grateful for my parents. So how would you know if you're a youth or if you're a parent of a youth or a friend of a youth, if they have hearing loss or if they could be susceptible to hearing loss because they listen to music through earbuds often? The best way to treat this is to visit a licensed audiologist. Have that youth undergo a hearing test and ensure that they meet the normal thresholds. If they don't, no worries. There are solutions in today's world of high tech, and hearing aids are my favorite. But of course, I'm a little biased. So what do you think about this study? Does it make sense to you that youth today have hearing loss more prevalently than youth 20, 25 years ago? Yeah, believe it or not, the 80s and the 90s are already like 20 to 30 years ago. I'm like, wait, what? This is crazy and time is flying by, but we should be aware of that and we should aid our hearing as much as we aid our eyesight. If you have any questions for me, please let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. I look forward to making more great videos for you. Stay strong, stay amazing, and have a great day.